But first tonight, Tony Mokbel's lawyers are rubbishing claims that he plans to take down police in the fallout from his plea deal. A controversial former jail inmate has made sensational suggestions about the drug baron's trade-off for a chance at freedom one day. Ten's Mark O'Brien joins us live now for more on this backroom deal. Mark, how significant could this deal be?
Yes, Mel, well, the importance of what Mokbel knows cannot be underestimated. And tonight, there are sensational claims from a former prisoner who knows the system inside and out. Now, it's important to note that Mokbel's lawyers have hotly denied these claims. It's understood that Mokbel's lawyers, the drug kingpin's lawyers, have done a deal with prosecutors for a 20-year jail term. But of course, ultimately, that will be a matter for the court to decide.
Former high-flying lawyer Andrew Fraser knows Tony Mokbel. They were in jail together, both for drug crimes.
I think Mokbel's a pretty smart man. He's got a very healthy ego, though, and loved the high life, loved the showing off, but on the other hand was very cagey about what he was up to.
Caginess, that's probably come in handy. Fraser claims Mokbel has done a deal with prosecutors to seek a lighter sentence for the three drug offences he's pleaded guilty to.
And he would also have had to kick in one hell of a lot of information to get to the position he's in now. Because when you boil it all down, it's a very large amount of drugs. There's a lot of cases that the Crown have walked away from. So you don't get that without something in return.
That something, according to Fraser, would be spectacular.
He's in jail. He told me stuff that left me speechless as far as police corruption was concerned. And not just the volumes of money involved, but the number of police involved.
Mokbel's lawyers have issued a statement denying he'll give any evidence against others, including corrupt police. This is completely untrue, say his solicitors.
Well, I don't think Andrew Fraser knows anything about this case, and I don't think he knows what he's talking about.
Peter Farris QC was one of the defence lawyers who brokered the agreement.
The terms of it are confidential, but more, no doubt, will be disclosed on the plea hearing in 8 weeks' time.
There are claims the Office of Public Prosecutions will seek a 20-year jail term.
But a grubby little man who has traded his life on the misery of people's lives will now have a good time to come, apparently, to sit and think about it.
So 20 years enough?
Well, we don't yet know whether 20 years is the sentence.
Ultimately, the length of Mokbel's sentence will be a matter for the judge, the police chief putting himself at length from the sentencing process.
The police haven't done a deal with Tony Mokbel. That's not true. The prosecution, the Director of Public Prosecutions is responsible for the prosecution of Tony Mokbel. There's obviously been negotiations going on some time.
Fraser says the deal is sealed.
If he's had anything to say, he's already said it.
What about the code of silence?
The code of silence or the code of silence died with the drug industry. If he swears up to what he's told me, it'll be breathtaking.
Would he be at risk?
Probably.
And finally, what's the word of a former prisoner worth?
I had a drug problem and I went to jail for it. That doesn't mean I can't tell the truth.
Mark O'Brien, 10 News.